Your eyes can see, your ears can hear money going down the tubes. Every day, your company manufactures a product that it doesn't package, doesn't sell. This product transports the energy that is so vital to your plant's operation. Your ears and eyes can tell you whether that product is being conserved or wasted. That product is steam. Steam is a necessary utility for industry, an efficient energy carrier that can be generated in a central boiler and transported through pipes by means of its own pressure to perform a variety of tasks: cooking, drying, comfort heating, or temperature control in numerous manufacturing processes. Maintaining that efficiency has become increasingly important in the last decade as the costs of generating steam have escalated. Steam traps, when properly functioning, contribute greatly toward maintaining that efficiency. They hold the steam in the system while automatically removing the condensate and non-condensables that rob heat from the steam, reducing efficiency. When traps don't function properly, heat is lost, steam is lost, dollars are lost. These lost dollars affect the economic health of your company and you. The only reasonable way to ensure your steam system operates at peak efficiency is to establish a regularly scheduled preventive maintenance program. This job falls to the plant's energy technicians. An energy technician, like a physician, has to use his faculties, sight and hearing, to gather information. Then he must apply all of his training and experience to evaluate the results. Locating one malfunctioning trap among thousands and then rectifying the fault is a difficult task, but following these guidelines, as outlined in the companion flowchart, will make the job easier. Troubleshooting any system is simply a matter of taking a logical step-by-step approach to finding a given problem. In steam systems, the first step is to make sure the system is on and stable. The second step is to make sure that steam actually reaches the part of the system in question. If the trap is hot, the lines ahead of it are probably open. There are many ways to tell if a trap is hot. They range from squirting the trap with water to using an infrared detector on traps that are hard to reach. Cold traps could be an indication of clogged distribution piping or equipment, a closed valve, or a plugged strainer or drip leg ahead of the trap. If all the lines and equipment in front of the trap are functioning properly, but the trap is still cold, it has probably failed closed or is airbound. If the trap is hot, you must answer several questions about the system, the piping, and the trap itself in order to proceed. You must know the supply pressure and temperature, the condensate load, and the back pressure to the trap. Any of these measurements, or a combination of them, may exceed the design limitations of the trap for a number of reasons. If they do, the trap can't possibly function as it was designed to. Traps are used in comfort control and other systems where the steam pressure is varied according to demand. Therefore, you should also determine whether the pressure to the trap is constant or modulating. You should determine if the return piping is elevated or gravity drained. If it is elevated and there is modulating or low pressure to the trap, the line may not always drain, resulting in increased back pressure. In such a case, some traps will appear to have failed. In fact, the trap may be fine. The problem can only be found by checking the system. Obviously, if there's a problem in the system design or in trap selection, it will have to be corrected before any further tests can be performed. Sometimes, when conditions are extreme, traps cycle very slowly. Therefore, you must be very patient before deciding a trap has failed closed, if any system condition is near the trap's maximum or minimum ratings. Finally, you should know what type of trap is under consideration, because each has its own characteristics in testing and must be considered individually. There are two accepted methods of testing individual traps. The first is visual. If you are lucky, the trap was installed with shutoff valves to the trap and return line, as well as a test valve which allows the trap to discharge to atmosphere. If so, the most reliable method, sight, can be used. To perform this test, you must first close the shutoff valves to the trap and return line, isolating the trap from the system. Next, open the test valve. When you open the shutoff valve to the trap, reconnecting it to the system, the trap output can be observed downstream of the test valve. A trap that never opens to pass air or condensate is locked shut. A trap that continually passes live steam is failed open. Unfortunately, visual testing is complicated by the presence of flash steam. Some condensate flashes back into steam whenever it is vented to a lower pressure, in this case, atmosphere. Flash steam, which should be ignored when testing a trap, is lazier than live steam and lighter in color. In many instances, however, it takes experience to differentiate between live and flash steam. The second most reliable testing method is listening to the sounds made by traps in service. For this method, you must use a tool to localize the sounds you wish to hear. The tool may be as simple as a screwdriver with a bit held to the trap and the handle to your ear. An even better tool is a mechanic's stethoscope. These devices provide a good means of listening to the mechanical sounds of a trap. An ultrasonic detector is the best listening device to use when troubleshooting a steam system because it allows you to hear the high-frequency sounds generated by steam and condensate flow. The pickup for any of these devices should be placed near the outlet in order to hear the discharge from the trap. When testing multiple trap installations, such as a manifold where a number of traps discharge into a common return header, be sure that you listen to all the traps. Since metal is such a good conductor of sound, the signal is usually telegraphed from trap to trap. Normally, the trap that has failed has the loudest signal of the group. In any manner you test a trap, the specific arrangement of its parts and the operating principles that govern its behavior give visual and oral clues as to its performance. The ultrasonic detector used in the following tests is typical of most such devices and should provide a dependable means of comparison. The frequency response of these units, however, may vary by model and manufacturer. Therefore, the actual sounds you encounter in the field may differ somewhat from those reproduced by this tape. The IB trap is a mechanical trap that drains equipment continually, although its discharge is usually intermittent. Its action is controlled by a bucket which is inverted and attached to the valve by means of a lever. When the bucket is surrounded by condensate and two-thirds filled with steam, it rises, lifting the valve to a point where it is snapped shut by the condensate velocity near the orifice. When the bucket is only one-third filled with steam, its weight, combined with the mechanical advantage of the lever, pulls the valve from the seat, opening the trap. Air is continually passed through a small hole in the top of the bucket, called a bucket vent. You should be able to see and hear the intermittent discharge of a properly functioning IB. If there is no discharge, the bucket vent is probably plugged and the trap airbound. A continuous light discharge from an IB probably indicates that the trap is dribbling. This is the normal operating mode for IBs when the condensate load is a very small percentage of the trap's capacity, such as in drip or tracer applications. If there is a continuous heavy discharge from the trap, check the condensate load. It is probably approaching the maximum capacity of the trap. If it is not, the valve may be worn or blocked partially open by dirt or scale. If you can hear the rushing of steam accompanied by the sound of the bucket rattling against the trap body, the trap has lost its prime. The prime of an IB is the water seal above the bucket, which prevents live steam from escaping when the valve is open. To determine if the trap has lost its prime, simply close the valve ahead of the trap and wait for condensate to build up in the drip leg. After a short time, which will vary with the load, reopen this valve slowly and allow the trap to catch its prime once again. If the trap catches prime, then you must try to determine why prime was lost. If it will not, then it is malfunctioning. Whether a malfunctioning IB can be repaired or must be changed out depends on which trap is used. The disc trap is an intermittent drainage and discharge device that has only one moving part, the controlled disc itself. Condensate and air arriving at the trap push the disc off the seat. The flow velocity under the disc increases dramatically when steam or flash steam is present. The resulting pressure reduction here, combined with the pressure rise caused by steam passing above the disc, snap it down onto the seat. Because the disc trap's performance when it discharges to atmosphere may not resemble its operation in service, where it is subject to back pressure, visual testing of the disc trap is not recommended. The action of the disc, however, makes it one of the easier traps to test by sound. We'll use a glass discharge line so you can see the action that accompanies the sound. You should be able to hear about 6 cycles per minute in a properly functioning disc trap that is correctly sized. If the cycle rate is high, above 15 times per minute, then the trap is leaking steam and should be repaired or replaced. If the trap is discharging continuously, listen for the sound of steam rushing through the trap. If that is not heard, the trap is probably responding to a heavy condensate load, and you should check for proper sizing. If steam is heard passing through the trap, it is malfunctioning. Disc traps usually fail open. If the trap doesn't cycle at all, it is probably airbound or clogged with dirt. Dirt can also lodge between the disc and seat of the trap, causing it to leak steam. Many disc traps can be disassembled for cleaning. Remember to check the system conditions as well as the trap. The disc trap is especially susceptible to problems brought on by high back pressure. When back pressure exceeds 50% of the inlet pressure, the disc will remain open for longer periods of time. If the back pressure rises high enough, the trap will lock open. Since disc traps operate according to the thermodynamic principle, pouring cold water on a disc trap that is not steam jacketed increases the cycle rate. This may give you a better feel for the trap's internal operation. Thermostatic traps, such as bellows and bimetallic, also respond to temperature. An element inside the trap's body, either a liquid-charged bellows, which expands when heated, or a bimetallic strip, which flexes when temperature rises, reacts to open and close the valve directly. On medium to heavy loads, these traps discharge intermittently. On light loads, they have a tendency to modulate. No discharge at all could indicate a trap plugged with dirt or a bellows element that has failed closed. Bellows traps designed to close at saturated steam temperature usually fail this way. Worn valves or seats or dirt lodged between the valve and seat of these traps cause the trap to leak steam between cycles. This can be detected by a high-pitched rushing sound or by the discharge of live steam mixed with flash steam and condensate between cycles. These are among the hardest traps to evaluate, however, because the discharge of a leaking trap appears so similar to the condensate and flash steam output of a trap that is modulating because of a light load. The important difference is a trap that is leaking discharges live steam. Failure in a trap that fails open is usually detected by the sight and sound of a large amount of live steam discharge. Bellows traps that are designed to open just below steam saturation temperature usually fail open. Most thermostatic traps, whether bellows or bimetallic, may be disassembled in the field and cleaned or repaired. One helpful thing to remember when testing any thermostatic trap is that it should always be open at room temperature. Finally, we will consider the testing of F&T traps. This is a combination mechanical thermostatic trap. It has a closed float which senses the density difference between condensate and steam. The float is connected directly to a valve that modulates with the condensate level in the trap. The thermostatic valve is located near the top of the trap. When this space is below steam temperature, the valve is open, venting a mixture of air and some live or flash steam. As the temperature rises inside the trap, the bellows expands, closing the valve. Thereafter, it should open intermittently to vent non-condensables. A properly functioning F&T has a modulating discharge of condensate and flash steam. This is sometimes accompanied by the intermittent bursts of the thermostatic valve as it vents air. If there is a constant rushing of steam, one of the valves is leaking or blocked open by dirt. Since F&T traps drain continuously, a moderate steam leak may be hard to hear. If this is true, closing a valve on either side of the trap for a few minutes will back up condensate. When the valve is reopened, the float valve should swing wide open to drain the backed up condensate. The discharge should be quieter now, without the high-pitched rush of live steam. Since both the float and the bellows element are relatively fragile, they can be ruptured fairly easily, causing the trap to fail. Most F&Ts can be disassembled in the field for cleaning and inspection. Inspection will determine if the trap should be repaired or changed out. These are guidelines for troubleshooting your steam systems and testing your traps. They may be easy to learn in and of themselves, but applying them takes patience, practice, experience. Every bit of knowledge you can acquire about steam systems, steam traps, their operation, and repair will be a benefit to your performance and that of your company. Your Armstrong representative can provide you with many educational aids, catalogs, videotapes, flowcharts, testing guides, reprints, audio cassettes, and bulletins to further your knowledge of steam-related equipment. At Armstrong, we believe that knowledge not shared is energy wasted. Produced for Armstrong by AVP.